In today's episode, Ravi asks, what steps should we take to ensure security and confidentiality when using tools like ChatGPT or Bard? Well, that's easy. Don't put confidential secure information into these things ever. Not too long ago, ChatGPT had 100,000 accounts compromised. Hackers got access to the accounts and were able to see the history in them. You should not be putting any kind of sensitive information in these tools at all. Because even if they were perfectly secure from third parties, you are still putting information that is yours into a system that is not yours, right? That is someone else's system. So don't do it. And that's the easy answer. Suppose you want to use large language models on sensitive or protected information. How do you do that safely? The safest way to do that is to run a large language model locally. And there are tools that allow you to do this, one of which is called GPT for All. So GPT, the number for all.io. This is a public open source project. It's a web app. No, it's a desktop app you run on your computer, Windows, Linux, or Mac, and it installs an interface. And then you download one of many different models, you know, a Llama, Vicuna, you name it. What happens next is once you've downloaded the model of your choice, assuming you agree, you know, you uncheck the share my information, that model runs locally on your computer. And it's not going to be as fast as ChatGPT, right? It's not going to be as thorough. It will have more limitations. But anything you put in it never, ever leaves your computer. It never even goes on your local network. It just goes on your computer. The responses you get are only on your computer. And so as long as your computer doesn't get stolen, that data is safe. That is the safest way to use a large language model with sensitive or secure or confidential information. You absolutely do not want to be putting that into any third party, even if that third party is saying, yes, we protect your data. Really? Inevitably, with any kind of third party service, someone has to audit these things. Someone has to, from time to time, you know, take a sample and make sure it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. And if you're putting in confidential information, other people can see that. Right? Now, yes, it's going to be in there with a gazillion other people's responses and you know what they've been using the software for. But the reality still is, if you're putting in third-party information, it is at risk. And there's no way to fix that, right? There's no way to not have that happen. So I would download and install one of these tools. They are free, they are open source, and they are local. And that makes all the difference for secure and confidential information. Now, for non-secure stuff, like, oh, you know, let's write an outline for a blog post about marketing automation. Sure, you can use ChatGPT for that. You can use Bard or Bing. Because in instances like that, you're not going to be causing, you know, substantial problems. Rewrite this email in a professional tone, right? As long as there's not substantial personal identifying information in the email, you can absolutely do that in a ChatGPT. So the easiest way to think about it is this. Would I email the contents of what I'm going to hand into to a ChatGPT? Would I be okay just mailing that to a member of the general public? Just email it to some random person on the street. Would I be okay with that? Would my company be okay with that? If it's like, you know, you're trying to figure out a way to more tactfully phrase a memo about, you know, please stop microwaving fish in the common room microwave, that's a pretty obvious yes. Like, yeah, I'll hand that to any stranger. Like, hey, jerk, stop doing that. Right. You know, and that would be the prompt, and of course the response would be, please let's avoid doing this. But if you were putting the contents of an email saying, like, hey, here's the third quarter sales numbers, I wouldn't give that to some random person on the street. Right? I wouldn't give that to a potential competitor. That's the easy benchmark as to what you should put into these tools and not is. Would you hand it to another person without reservation? If the answer is no, use one of the local models instead. It's a good question. It's an important question. That's a question people are not thinking about enough. So, Ravi, good job for thinking about it. Thanks for asking. We'll talk to you next time. If you like this video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button.